Welcome to the SCP Foundation Integrated File Server. To begin, please insert your Foundation personnel badge into the card reader. Authorization. Approved. Please select item's numerical code to view. Processing. Your file is ready to view.
Item hashtag, SCP-3068 Object Class, Euclid Keter Special Containment Procedures. Several long-range Scranton reality cannons are trained on SCP-3068. These are to fire upon any containment breaches by SCP-3068A instances, preventing these instances from existence in ordinary space without the need for costly physical assaults. It should be noted that Scranton reality cannons are an unstable prototype. Their usage is to be restricted to SCP-3068 only. Extreme caution must be observed in their operation. A diplomatic presence is to be maintained on SCP-3068 at all times. Travel to and from SCP-3068 is to take place using vessels fitted with a Scranton reality engine. Again, this is an unstable prototype which should only be operated with extreme caution. Update September 7, 2016, attempts to locate SCP-3068-B are currently underway. Current protocol is to take SCP-3068-B in for questioning, with the intention of ascertaining its exact link to SCP-3068. Update May 10, 2017, all use of Scranton reality cannons and Scranton reality engines is to be halted following Incident 3068-1. Scranton reality cannons and Scranton reality engines have now been classified as SCP-3068-A233 and SCP-3068-A234 respectively. A full investigation into how these devices were first developed is underway. Due to the distance of 6,070 light-years between Earth and Cygnus X-1, there is no current way to return the currently stationed Foundation diplomats to Earth without SCP-3068-234. Research into alternative methods of transport is currently underway. Description: SCP-3068 is the space station Halicon Light Beta, currently in orbit around Cygnus X-11. SCP-3068 is spherical in shape, with several branching arms extending off it at random points and ending in smaller spheres, with further interconnections and branches extending off these. It is composed of an alloy made up of chrome, titanium, and an unknown substance which the inhabitants call Meconite trademark. SCP-3068 is run by a military administration composed of humans who state that they are representatives of the Union of Earth, which they claim is a governing body comprising one-third of the Milky Way. According to the administration, the rest of the galaxy is largely split between the tyrannical Lalandi Imperium, which has enslaved a number of species and is planning on assaulting SCP-3068 in the near future, and the Carae United Caravanserais, a mercantile confederation of city-states. The Carae are said to control the shipping of several crucial goods, including Corazion Paradoxes, a substance said to be vital to SCP-3068's operation. SCP-3068's population is composed of a number of different alien species who claim to originate on a large variety of different worlds, some unknown or apparently non-existent. Investigation of some of the real worlds which these species claim to originate from has revealed no signs of their existence. These different species are hereafter referred to as SCP-3068-A instances. The inhabitants uniformly believe that it is currently the late 30th century. They are in possession of unknown and extremely advanced technology, allowing SCP-3068 to continue its orbit of Cygnus X-1 despite the apparent physical impossibility. A variety of spacefaring vessels enter and leave SCP-3068 each day. However, they abruptly appear or disappear one light-year away from SCP-3068, being apparently unable to exist too far from SCP-3068's confines. Observations from within SCP-3068 and the surrounding area appear to show these ships continuing on their journey. SCP-3068's apparent purpose is as an intergalactic marketplace and meeting place. A large and thriving commercial sector and an equally vibrant black market are both present on the station. The black market is clandestinely run by several members of SCP-3068-A24, referred to as Lalandites, whom SCP-3068's administration claims are at war with the Empire of Earth. At random intervals, new branches and spheres abruptly appear on SCP-3068. These are often accompanied by sudden alterations to the structure and organization of SCP-3068, often with the inhabitants being unaware of any alterations. Sometimes, alterations to the external political organization will also occur. The Union of Earth, for instance, was formerly the United Nations of Earth. SCP-3068 first appeared on September 10, 2010, when it was suddenly detected by Foundation long-distance scanners. Point 2. At this point, it had no branches, and was simply a single sphere. The first branches appeared on October 12, 2010. Foundation teams were immediately dispatched. The Foundation has maintained a permanent diplomatic presence on SCP-3068 since February 3, 2011. The following is a list of particularly notable SCP-3068-A instances. SCP-3068-A instance name of instance descriptions. SCP-3068-A7 halogen large, green and with prominent tentacles. The halogen are known for their unusual language, which lacks any syntax or consistent vocabulary. It is considered impossible to learn by non-halogen, although they themselves often have a strong grasp of English. SCP-3068-A24 Lalandites have a human appearance, with the exception of their gray skin and glowing white eyes. Initial encounters with Lalandites revealed them to be uniformly duplicitous and cruel. This abruptly changed on September 11, 2014, when they suddenly and uniformly gained a large number of rites, rituals, and tragic backstories. The Lalandites purportedly originate on an unknown planet orbiting Lalandi 21185, capital of the Lalandi Imperium. As of September 11, 2015, the Lalandites are in charge of SCP-3068. SCP-3068-A47 Carae, a mercantile race whose DNA matches that of the order Hymenoptera. The Carae are humans with the heads, wings, and coloring of the common wasp, Vespula vulgaris. The Carae act as intergalactic merchants, with a presence in every port. They have been known to sell Nomichan hypercrystals, Lalandite spices, and Corazion paradoxes to Foundation diplomats, among other wares. They purport to represent the United Carae Caravanserais. SCP-3068-A63 Children of the Satellite, a race of cyborgs, who possess originally organic minds digitally transferred into metallic bodies. The construction and materials used for their bodies are reminiscent of those used by NASA in the 20th century, although some elements are reminiscent of Foundation long-distance probes. Worship the screamer who is lost in space, whose desire for revenge is a constant of emotional perfection. SCP-3068-A65-Z93291 The self-designation of a race of hypothetical beings, whose existence is inferred by their actions. A database entry, quarters, and diplomatic treatises purportedly written by them exist, but they have never been observed. Supposedly represent the Alliance of Conceptual Beings. SCP-3068-A79 Unknown does not appear on SCP-3068's database, but has been witnessed by 9 Foundation diplomats, always while they are alone. Several members of the species will abruptly manifest, stare at the individual, say the line "I left because of you, Desmond," and then demanifest. They appear as Caucasian humans, wearing gray pinstripe suits, but lacking any facial features. They have occasionally been observed holding a lit cigar in their right hand. SCP-3068-A86 Anafabulites Data Lost Addendum 1, on August 1, 2014, the intercom system of a Foundation vessel approaching SCP-3068 abruptly began to broadcast a spoken message over a track of orchestral music. A transcript is as follows. It is the year 2914. At the edge of known space, on the fringes of what is good and evil, lies the final outpost of the Union of Earth. The brave men of the Union Navy man their posts, holding the line against all that seeks to threaten the human way of being, crafty merchants, cruel tyrants, and the endless menace of the Lalandites. But the men of the Navy are brave, fearless, and without fear. For no man nor alien need fear aboard Halicon Light Beta. Starring, John Cusack as Captain Adrian Oldenburg, Edward James Olmos as Commander Juan Santos, Winona Ryder as Maria Oldenburg, Simon Sebag Montefiore as Security Chief Judas Priest, Tom Hiddlestone as Dr. Mark Limey Jones, the SCP Foundation as itself with Mark Ruffalo as Emperor Claude Moran, and introducing Cornelius Halliwell as the voice of Mura Bear. Written by Desmond Sykes, directed by Desmond Sykes. Following this, All Foundation vessels approaching SCP-3068 were subject to the same effect, with minor alterations to the text of the broadcast. Addendum 2, on September 11, 2015, an abrupt change occurred in SCP-3068. 17 new branches and spheres appeared on its surface, and the entire history and political balance of the station abruptly altered. The Lalandites were suddenly in control of the station, each with a significantly altered backstory and personality. They are now mostly sympathetic to the station's populace, but find themselves unable to reconcile their political situation with their personal conscience. They are opposed by a resistance movement present on several of SCP-3068's decks, primarily composed of the former human administration and several prominent Kerae. All of these individuals have developed significant personal problems, including large numbers of extramarital affairs and numerous incidents involving substance abuse. A vast illegal drugs network is now present in the station. Several members of both the Lalandites and the Human Resistance have espoused a vague form of ideology they call anarcho-atheist capitalism as a solution. Foundation diplomatic efforts have continued unabated. Incident 3068-1, on 25/12/2016, a containment breach occurred. 38 new species suddenly appeared, including a large humanoid creature composed of fire, classified SCP-3068-A105, a human-shaped absence of light and space, classified SCP-3068-A143, and a vast sperm whale, classified SCP-3068-A199. These three species all immediately headed towards Earth at a speed of 1 light-year per minute, following extensive bombardment by SCP-3068. They were swiftly attacked and taken down by the Foundation's experimental Scranton reality cannons. The containment procedures have been fully revised to prepare more swiftly for similar incursions. Following this incident, Agent Cartwright, a security agent attached to the Foundation diplomatic mission to SCP-3068, found a small handwritten note in his quarters. A transcript is as follows. "Darker and edgier, needs to be more adult, I'm almost 15 now. Snargawl's Lalandites take over station? Don't want to make it so brightly colored, complex protagonists, complex villains Lalandites? Needs darkini need to prove to dad can write something more mature, so shall transfer this kitty thing into something more mature and dark and edgy. Am an adult now. Good god this was pretentious, let's just go full Dadaist. Give them reality cannon, sounds better than space guns also transport, reality drive? Engine?" Following this, Foundation vessels undertook a large-scale investigation of any Shinnok activity surrounding SCP-3068. A large Shinnok impulse, consistent with reality-bending humanoids, was found to originate from Earth and was being broadcast towards SCP-3068. Desmond Sykes has now been classified as SCP-3068-B. Attempts to locate SCP-3068-B are currently underway. Footnotes 1. One of the closest black holes to Earth. Two investigations are still occurring as to how this occurred, due to the apparent limits of Foundation scientific equipment.